Welcome back, everyone. In this week's video, I'm going to go over the new AI masking features in Capture One. Those of us who have been using this program for quite a while have been hearing the Lightroom users brag about what they can do. Well, now is our chance to use this technology. I want to start off by giving you my disclosures up front, though. I have spoken before on behalf of Capture One at an event at a camera store, and they did provide me with the software that I'm using today. However, they're not paying me to make this video today. They don't even know that I'm making this video today. I just found that all of these new tools that we have at our disposal are so good that I wanted to share it with you because it's changed the way that I use the software and it's really helping me to polish my images. So let's go ahead and get started with some images that I took at a recent workshop, and we'll get going with this one of Colleen. So I've already made some basic adjustments to this image. I've also added Capture One's Beyond Film Style K100 version 1 as a layer. That's given me a huge, it's really graded the image and made it look great. Here's the before and here is the after. So you can see that it makes a big difference just adding that. Now what I feel, how I feel about this image is that the background is a little dull, a little too blended into her hair and that sort of thing. Now we're going to do some AI masking. I'm going to go up here and I'm going to click on the background mask. It's going to analyze the image and then pick out the background. It's already done it. I'm going to press M here to show you what the mask is currently showing our background. And then I just am going to brighten the background a little bit. I'm going to bring up those shadows and bring up those blacks a little bit so that I can get her to stand out from the background just a little bit more. So here it is without the background adjustment, and here it is with the background adjustment. I think that looks great. Now I'm going to show you a picture of Isabel, and we're going to start adjusting the subject a little bit using the AI masking. All right, so here's our image of Isabel straight out of the camera. I'm not going to use the Beyond Film looks on this image. I'm actually going to change the base characteristics from auto to high contrast. I just want a little poppier feel for this image because it's sort of supposed to have that film noir sort of old Hollywood vibe going on. I feel like the image just needs to be brightened up a little bit. And once again, I'm going to bring those shadows and blacks up just a little bit too. Now you'll notice right away that I think her hand looks too bright. So I'm going to go ahead and grab and make a new layer here. I'm going to come up here and grab the AI masking brush, which can be found right here. I'm going to hover over her hand and I am going to let the AI masking do its work. And now it's done. It's analyzed the image and you can see that her hand is now red. I'm going to go ahead and press and hold on her hand. And I'm going to press the M key and that will confirm that her hand is what's selected right now in the mask. I feel that her hand is a little too bright, so I'm going to bring it down about 2/3 of a stop, maybe half a stop. Yeah, I'll bring the brightness down a little bit too. And we're just making it so that it matches her face a little bit more. The next thing that has been a huge improvement on my work with the AI masking is getting more hair detail. A lot of times when you're photographing a subject with really dark hair, those shadow areas can sort of block up a little bit and we lose detail. So I'm going to make a new layer. I'm going to come over with the AI mask feature again, and I'm going to select her hair. So right now we've got half of her hair selected. I'm going to hold down Shift key and mouse over here to the other side of her face. And okay, well, in this instance, it didn't do it perfectly. I'm going to press and hold Shift and I'm going to tap again. And now I've got the other side of her hair, but I've also got a bit of her face involved in the mask. So I'm going to press M. And now there is a new feature called the AI Eraser tool. So I'm going to grab it over here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go over her face and you see instantly it recognizes her face and I'm just going to press and click on her face. And now that blue area is going to be removed from our mask. It's grabbed her neck. I'm going to press it again and it's gone. I'm going to go over this shadow here underneath her hand, press it again, and that's gone. So now my mask actually looks a lot better and it was pretty quick. So I'm going to press the M key to make the mask go away, and I'm going to come over here and I'm not making the mask go away. I'm making the image showing me the mask go away. I'm going to pull the shadows up a little bit, and I'm going to pull the blacks up a little bit. I'm going to hold down the hand, press the hand key, double tap on her face. That hand key just sort of makes it so that I'm sure that I'm not masking anything else. And here it is before, and here it is after. All right, now I'm going to zoom out here, and I'm going to select the backgrounds. I'm just going to press the AI background selection tool because I feel like the background is a little too bright. I'm going to press M to make that show up again, and that's great. I am going to now pull down that brightness a little bit. That feels good. I'm going to make a separate mask over here, and I'm going to grab that AI masking brush tool because I feel like this little highlight is a little too bright. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press and hold and drag to the right. And I'm going to press the M key, and you'll show that what that did is that selected that area of the background. And now I'm just going to use this exposure and brightness tool a little bit to bring that down. And I'm going to zoom in here just to make sure that this looks flawless and seamless. That feels pretty good. Okay, so in case you were wondering, here it is before and here it is after. So we made a big difference here, just adding those details back in and polishing our image. And I actually shot this image as part of a tutorial for my members only website, The Academy with John Gress. I might've said earlier that I shot the photos during a workshop. This one was during an Academy tutorial. So if you wanna check that out, you can. There's a 3-day free trial. Just go to johngress.com/academy. I also wanted to take a moment to tell you about a giveaway that I'm doing. I've partnered with Studio Titan to give away 3 camera stands, including the one that I use in my studio, and I absolutely love it. The way you can win one of these camera stands is to enter your work at photocontest.johngress.com. You can enter 3 different categories: portrait, boudoir, and product photography. Then after you've entered, send a link to your work to your friends and ask them to vote on your entry. Then on February 2nd, 2024, myself, Jeff Carpenter, and Yulia Pinchenko will judge the finalists from each category and pick the final winners live on YouTube. So to enter, just go to photocontest.johngress.com today. Now I've got this third image of Izzy pulled up here, and you'll notice I made a little bit of a mistake with the lighting. I got it a little too focused on her face and not enough on her body. So we're going to use the AI masking tool here to select the subject. So I'm going to click over here on select subject, and it's going to analyze the image once again. Great. I'm going to press M to see what we've selected here. Now, I actually don't want to change her face. I want to change the rest of her body and not her face. So I'm going to press M. I'm going to grab that AI eraser tool again. I'm going to hover over her face and just tap on it. Great. And now we have her body selected, but not her face, including her hair. So I'm going to press the M tool to make that preview go away. And I'm just going to bring up our exposure here a little bit on her body and probably bring those blacks up a little bit and the shadows up a little bit too. I think that looks pretty good. And yeah, now I'm going to make a new mask, and I'm going to make an AI mask of her hair. That did a pretty good job. It looks like it left some of it out though. I'm going to grab the regular brush tool. I'm going to use the right. I'm going to right click and grab auto mask here. And I'm just going to paint in this area of her hair that wasn't in the original mask. And that auto mask should work to give us a reasonably decent edge there. I'm going to press the M key again. I'm going to go ahead and bring up the blacks again and bring up those shadows a little bit. All right. Now I think the one last thing would be here to adjust her neck a little bit. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the AI brush tool again, and I'm just going to drag and drop over her neck just like that. I'm going to press the M key to show you what we've selected. That looks pretty good. I'm just going to bring the brightness down of her neck a little bit, Because what I want overall is I want people's eyes to go up to her face and not focus on other parts of the body. And so I think that looks pretty good. Here's after the neck adjustment and here's before. And if I zoom out here and show you the entire image, and then I go and show you the before and after, here is the before and here is the after. Well, I think that about wraps it up. As you can see, these AI masking tools in Capture One are really powerful and it's really gonna change the way that we do our work. I know it's already changed the way that I do mine and that's why I had to get on here and share it with you today. If you'd like to check out my workshops, just go to johngress.com/workshops. Again, if you wanna check out my Academy tutorials, go to johngress.com/Academy. And if you have any questions or comments, just leave those below. And if you wanna help support me in a different way, you could click on the links in the description to Capture One and some of the gear that I use in my studio, and that'll help out as well. Thanks again, have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.